Hi, I'm Evangeline.
I'm Bethany.
I'm Alex.
I'm Wendy.
I'm Michaela.
And today we're going to be talking about Auntie Anne's pretzels and chili. Let's get started.
So I'm going to start this presentation by talking about some background story about Auntie Anne, which is our company. We first started back in 1988, February 2nd, when our founder, Ann Beller, bought a stand in a farmer market in Downingtown, Pennsylvania. We serve products like pretzel nuggets, pretzel dogs. They come along with different kind of dips, and we also serve with different kind of beverage, and also offer baking mix of pretzels. Our company has more than 1,500 stores worldwide, located in supermarkets, shopping malls, as well as airports, travel plazas, military bases, amusement park, and also university. Since 2014, we have 500 international locations worldwide, including places like Aruba, Egypt, Canada, Japan, Malaysia, Mexico, Saudi Arabia, United Kingdom, and also the United States. And now we'll have Alex and Michaela talk to us about why we choose chili.
Santiago Chile is a thriving powerhouse. With 40% of the Chilean population living in metropolitan and greater area Santiago, Auntie Anne's will be at the center of it all.
Santiago is home to many tourist resorts, banks, and bakeries that will stimulate business and competition for Auntie Anne's. All in all, Santiago Chile is a prime location for optimal visibility for new customers.
So I'll be talking about expanding the company. President Mike Shatuk says, entering countries and territories new to us is vital to our international expansion plans to grow Auntie Anne's as a globally recognized brand. With any type of market, you need to know who you're marketing to. In the 1900s, the Germans migrated over to Chile, and one of the things the Germans are known for is their pretzels. We're giving you a feel at home feeling, not just for Germany or Germans, for any other country that Auntie Anne's is in. That way, you kind of get a home away from home feeling.
The Chilean economy has been ranked 56 out of 189 economies as of 2015. The main reason why Auntie Anne's decided not to enter Chile is because of the poor economic state in 2013. They felt like they didn't want to take the risk of investment to lose any profits or revenue. But since 2016, the economy rose significantly. So I think it'll be a good decision for Auntie Anne's to operate in that economy now. Now we'll have Alex to talk about the startup costs and potential revenue.
Average estimated cost of opening the business ranges anywhere between $196,475 to $370,100. Average sales per unit on a yearly basis is $446,749. This leaves a great market of error or great margin for profits, especially starting up in a place like Santiago, Chile, that is thriving in its marketplace. Next, we will be presenting Wendy, who's going to be talking about laws.
Chilean government policy for foreign investment is liberal and open. There are two types of foreign investment laws in Chile. First one is the central bank and the second one is Decree Law 600. And we are going to run through Decree Law 600 because we have capitals and tangible assets. Decree Law 600 is also known as foreign investment status for the purpose of FDI. The policy in these laws including the ability to freely transfer net income abroad and the protection from discrimination of domestic companies. Decree Law 600 provides a good environment to foreigners to invest.
There will always be some element of risk to IPR. Chile, with strict and protective laws to protect intellectual property rights, it immensely decreases this risk. This provides reassurance and respect on behalf of a potential Auntie Anne's franchise in Chile.
Okay, guys, so because of all of these carefully evaluated points, we have decided to go with our product. Therefore, Auntie Anne's will be twisting its way into Chile. Thank you all for your time, and in just a moment, we'll be prepared to answer any of your questions.
Of foreign investment loans in Chile. First one is central bank loan and
alrighty, so the president Mike Shattuck, whoever,
your patents and copyrights and trademarks are always gonna be a threat. And okay, this is really bad, isn't it? Okay, it's fine. Intellectual property rights.
Yeah, I would...